I had a real downer 4 days. It was that my dad was visiting me on set. And he was like, are you always this sad?
She is the enigmatic star of hits like Ex Machina, Man from U.N.C.L.E. and the new Jason Bourne. She won an Oscar for The Danish Girl. And next, she's going to be the newly rebooted Lara Croft Tomb Raider. Basically, Alicia Vikander is the biggest thing to come from Sweden since flat-packed furniture. And she's all set to become one of the biggest stars in Hollywood.
Well, firstly, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So, last year you had this incredible year where there were 6 films that came out. And I want to know, what does it feel like when you've shot the film? The film is in the films are in the can and they haven't come out yet. Do you have a sense that they're going to be successful, or do you just not know?
It's, I would say when it's done, I normally have no clue. it's a weird feeling, that thing of being on set. You can never really know if a film is what it's going to turn out to be, if it's going to be good or bad or whatever. Of course, you know, you have hopes, but it's something when you're on a film set, you'll have the feeling of a group of people that all believe in something, and that working 14 hours a day or more, 6 day weeks, and being away from your families and friends is actually worth it. And it's something when you have that collective feeling, like, oh my God, it feels like we're doing some good shit. That's when, and then looking back afterwards, because then after the film's done, then my nerves just kick in. I was like, oh, whatever I thought is just right. Like, I have no idea, you know, and then I just start to overthink things. But then when I look back, when the film has come out and people enjoyed it, it's usually the films that I had a very, very good time shooting.
You don't necessarily have a premonition on the set of The Danish Girl that you're like, this is the one I'm going to win an Oscar for. You don't have that sense.
Not at all.
Alicia Vikander, The Danish Girl.
This is the first Oscar and nomination for Alicia Vikander.
It's quite a beautiful thing. The first time you see it with an audience, it's kind of a heightened version. I mean, I love going to the cinema. I love going to the movies myself. And it's something about sitting in a full audience and kind of feel like it's a collective vibe of whatever is happening. If the film lands and it's excitement. Yeah, you feel it in the room.
There's been so many films that have come out, but I wanted to go a little bit earlier to some of your earlier work. Is it true that when you were auditioning for A Royal Affair, you faked Danish, being able to speak Danish?
I mean, I had told them like 10 times. I was like, you do know that I don't speak Danish. I actually did my first reading with a casting director. And for that one, I had my friend's mother, who's half Danish, half Swedish, who was very kind and recorded on her iPhone and sent all the files on email. And I sat there trying to just repeat what she said. Nicolai Arcel, the director, is now very close friends now. And just a year ago, I was in LA and he was like, dude, come. And he was like, took out his computer. He was like, look at this. And he had found my old
audition tape.
My old audition tape. And he was like, what are you saying? I have no idea why you're saying this. But I kind of liked it, so thank God I brought you to Copenhagen for another round.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Look at the way she dresses, flaunting her ankles.
I don't think anyone is likely to be corrupted by seeing my ankles.
I was.
As a proud member of the European Union, who happens to be based in the UK, how do you feel about the UK stepping out of the EU?
For me, it meant everything at the borders in Europe were the way they were for me. I came and I was able to work, and I was able to educate myself, and also been working in film, and that you can bring talent from whatever, you know, country, especially in Europe. The whole idea of being able to collect from everywhere, and so for me it was a very sad day.
Do you want to be my friend?
Of course.
Will it be possible?
Why would it not be?
One of the most incredible films that you made that came out last year was Ex Machina. And a lot of that film is just you, Domhnall, and Oscar. And it's heavy emotional stuff to a large degree. It's very claustrophobic. How do you snap out of that when you're done filming?
We finished in Norway. It was just, I had a real downer. 4 days. It was that my dad was visiting me on set. It was like the first time he really had spent a couple of days on a set. He was like, are you always this sad? And I was like, the whole drive back to Sweden, we actually took a drive back from Norway, and I was just like, and we all, like, I think Donald and Oscar and Alex, we all texted. I was like, I'm just really sad now. And that's also talking about when it was really intense. We shot it in 5-6 weeks. Mm. It feels like a very emotional movie. And still I'm playing a robot. It doesn't really have whatever she has, emotions or not emotions.
She doesn't even have a neck and a head half the
time. No, but it's also very intellectual, but still it kind of is the words that bring out the action.
Wow. Thank you so much, the Academy, for this incredible recognition.
Since you've won the Oscar, do people relate to you differently? Have you sensed a shift in how people engage and talk to you?
No. I don't think. I mean, it's also been, I've been in a weird little bubble in the set. I actually went back to, they've done this so fast. I went back to set doing reshoots in London 2 days after the award show.
For Jason Bourne.
Yeah.
So you're like, I've got this Oscar. You just walk straight back on set.
I didn't even have it. I had left. I still haven't been back. So.
Wait, where is your Oscar statuette?
In LA. It was too, it's so heavy. You can't bring it on the flight.
Get extra baggage.
Yeah, I hope my friend takes good care of it, and I'll, yeah.
Alicia, good luck working out where to put your Oscar.
So surreal.
But it's been an absolute pleasure. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.